was fed of a black rock oil. A tainted sea's unwholesome spume. A scrap of pickled hydra skin. And blood from a traitor to her kin.
Mysterious as the nightmare in the moon. Project Obsidian?
Project Obsidian! It's a device that can destroy Cassandra's self-esteem!
Eugene! We are not attacking Cassandra!
Of course we're not going to attack her, Sunshine. I have to be prepared to protect our people from any contingency.
Princess, believe me, I don't want to hurt Cass either. But we can't promise that she's not going to try to hurt us.
Okay, I will sign it to protect Corona, but we won't need it because I know the cast we love is still in there somewhere.
Twilight, Applejack, Pinkie Pie, Rarity, and Fluttershy were gathered in the palace's grand hall, facing Princess Luna as she strode through the doorway. Princess Celestia waited at the back of the room.
Princess Luna! Applejack mentioned you needed Rainbow Dash for something important. Is she back yet? We were going to head out soon.
Luna shook her head.
Thy friend is far away, and swift though she is, she shan't return so quickly.
Twilight Sparkle raised an eyebrow at Luna's statement.
Far away? What do you mean?
Luna trotted forward. The group parted to allow her passage and followed.
Rest assured, it is a matter of crucial import, and a return shall merit a heroine's welcome.
Twilight turned to face her mentor.
Princess Celestia, did you know anything about this?
Princess Celestia stepped closer to the group of ponies.
My sister has acted faster than I expected her to, but I was aware of her concerns. Luna believes there is a great danger coming to Equestria, and she...
Celestia paused. She met her sister's gaze, and let a rare, awkward silence pass.
She has sent Rainbow Dash to recruit an ally.
More than that, sister! A savior!
Luna stomped a hoof, the blow echoing in the vaulted room.
Now that she is being retrieved, we can all breathe easy. No matter what danger is coming, we...
Not coming! It's already here!
The five ponies and their two sovereigns turned toward the vast double doors, where a teal Pegasus mare was struggling in the grasp of two royal guards. The mare was wide-eyed and haggard. Sweat shone on her hide and in her tangled mane, and a hastily wrapped bandage covered her right flank.
Apologies, Princess. She crashed into the topiary garden and then blew straight here. She was too fast for us,
said one of the guards. Twilight squinted, and then her eyes widened.
Hey, I remember you. From the academy. Lightning Dust, you nearly...
That's not important. You need to evacuate. Head as far north as you can, now.
Twilight, Rarity, Fluttershy, Pinkie Pie, and Applejack spoke up at once, peppering the Pegasus with questions.
I don't understand. What's going on?
Are you okay?
Hang on. Look, it's so important to leave the cast. What are you doing? Best honey, is anything going on? Does any pony have the slightest idea of what he's talking about?
Princess Celestia spread her wings for silence, and then spoke when the ponies complied.
Lightning Dust, please tell us what's happening.
Dust sagged in the guard's grip.
I don't really know, Princess. I tried to explain in Cloudsdale. There was this ram, but he wasn't a ram. More like a monster. And he did something to a volcano in the Badlands, and it...
The Badlands? That's halfway across Equestria from here. Why aren't you warning Dodge Junction or Appaloosa?
Dust winced and looked away. Her wings drooped.
Appaloosa and Dodge are gone.
The ponies standing before Dust shared a shocked silence. Applejack reacted first, her voice a faint whisper.
What do you mean, gone?
Dust closed her eyes against the ugly memory.
This huge wave of purple slime hit them. Covered everything. It moved on its own, like it was alive. And it was covered in these big, staring eyes. Every pony who got covered in it just gave up. They lay there in the muck and they wouldn't move. They hardly even breathed.
Dust shuddered. Her voice cracked. When she opened her eyes, they shone with tears.
I wanted to do right this time. I wanted to prove that I wasn't a... I tried to help them. I tried. I tried to tell them. But they weren't fast enough. I wasn't fast enough.
She huddled up and hung her head, slouching on the marble floor like a vulture.
I couldn't save them. I flew. I flew away. They wouldn't listen to me. Even in my own city, they wouldn't even stop what they were doing to hear what I had to say. They were more concerned with that stupid weather factory than with me telling them that they were all about to... And when the slime came, it happened so fast that I couldn't...
Expression did not falter. Twilight's eyes tightened. She swallowed despite her dry mouth.
And now this slime is coming this way?
Dust nodded silently. Twilight stomped a hoof and spread her wings in defiance.
Well, we are not gonna let it get to Canterlot, or to Ponyville, or anywhere else.
Her friends agreed with varying degrees of enthusiasm. Princess Celestia smiled proudly and nodded in approval. Princess Luna remained silent.
You sound just like him.
Pinkie Pie tilted her head.
Who?
The Sheriff and Dodge.
Twilight lowered her gaze, her wings folded.
Princess?
Celestia nodded.
Go. Go back to Ponyville, all of you. Protect the ones dear to you. And you, Lightning Dust? Spread the word in Cloudsdale. We'll send a royal escort with you this time. In the meantime, Luna and I will watch over Canterlot.
Her eyes met her sister's once more.
There is a lot we need to discuss.
For grab in the courtyard will take some getting used to, but if Dad thinks it's safer than out in the woods... Oh, Faith! There you are. Raps, I have something I need to tell you. Can we talk in private?
Oh, okay.
By sunset, a wall of piled sandbags encircled the outskirts of Ponyville in anticipation of the sinister flood. The town's ponies had worked together with diligence and song, finishing the work in record time. All of the youngest and oldest ponies were safe and sound on the upper floors of homes and buildings, and most things of value were packed up with them. A heavy silence fell over the town, full of tension and anticipation. Fluttershy set down a tray of refreshments for the breakwall workers, and then alighted on the town side of the new wall, folding her wings and knitting her brows.
It's so quiet,
she whispered.
A little too quiet!
My
Pinkie Pie hopped out from behind a dirt pile and began playing a raucous tune on a small coiled horn made of crystal. Her frizzy pink tail flopped to and fro in time with the honking notes. Several watchful ponies in the surrounding area jerked in surprise and then fixed the pink party pony with disapproving glares. Pinky's music petered out and stopped. She said through the horn and backed away sheepishly.
There, in the distance!
A Pegasus stallion hovering a few pony heights above Pinky pointed a hoof southward. A dark purple shadow was covering ground far in the distance, spreading toward Ponyville from the south, like the nightfall spreading from the east. The ponies at the wall leaped into action, double-checking its construction and shoring up thinner areas.
My Oodle seems so afraid of this thing.
Fluttershy hovered over to stand next to Pinky.
What should we do?
Pinky inhaled to speak, but then a full body spasm sent her wobbling back and forth. Her tail swirled and her eyelids fluttered. She finally came to rest after a straight-legged backflip. Fluttershy drew back in alarm.
Pinky! I've never seen get a pinky sense like that before. What does it mean?
Pinkie Pie was suddenly very, very quiet. She was still a stone for 5 heartbeats. But then she perked back up to her usual broad grin and loud, high voice.
It means we should go check on every pony else. Come on, Fluttershy!
Pinky bounded away, Fluttershy scrambling to take off and hover after her. At the center of town, Twilight Sparkle and her favorite assistant were hard at work organizing the preparation efforts. Twilight's horn was glowing, as were the dozen parchments and half-dozen quills orbiting around her. The pens all wrote at once, a testament to the Alicorn's burgeoning arcane power. Spike the Dragon was scurrying this way and that, maintaining Twilight's in-and-out boxes by toting fresh and completed checklists and papers. A few yards away, Rarity's horn was also aglow. 7 blue glowing canvas sacks were assembling themselves one by one as they hovered around her, casting shadows over her pristine white hide. Each bag was stitched to sandbag perfection and embroidered with her stylized R insignia. Pinky hopped over with a cheery smile.
Hey, Twilight! Hey, Rarity! Looks like the... whatever it is coming pretty soon. Have you seen Applejack anywhere? And is Dashy back yet?
Twilight's eyes didn't leave her work.
Applejack is fortifying Sweet Apple Acres. And Rainbow Dash is...
A few of the floating papers wavered.
Still not back yet.
Oh.
Pinkie Pie's smile lost an inch or two of width.
Okie dokie, then. If you see them, tell them...
Pinky pondered for a moment.
Tell them Pinky said to keep on smiling.
Will do.
Twilight was already half obscured by her swarming busy work, but the enchanted pages soon slowed once again.
Hold on. Why can't you just tell them you're...
Pinky was already gone.
What was that all about?
I don't know. Just Pinky being Pinky?
Spike passed by with a pile of inventory sheets.
Maybe so?
Rarity narrowed her well-decorated eyes.
Maybe not.
Fluttershy shrugged apologetically, at a loss to contribute to the conversation. Her front hooves were outstretched to receive Rarity's shipment of Haute Couture sandbags for delivery. The timid Pegasus took to the air and headed back to the breakwall's dirt pile to have the bags filled and distributed. But a few wing beats from the site, a shadow loomed in the southern distance. Fluttershy drifted to the ground, and the bags dropped. Fluttershy's jaw did likewise. A surging, boiling, purple-black tidal wave was building a few hundred yards from Ponyville. The vicious sludge lashed and lunged as it flowed, like a clot of worms writhing in a thin bag. The outer surface was dotted with staring, shallow-socketed eyes that rolled to and fro in mindless stares. The wave crested and fell, and a rolling wall of the slime streaked toward the breakwall at a galloping pace. All around Fluttershy, ponies broke and ran and flew in a panic, desperate to escape. Fluttershy stood in mute shock until a galloping earth pony jostled her aside and she snapped to her senses. She spread her wings and took flight seconds before the syrupy mass struck the sandbag wall. The first impact knocked half the sandbags flying, but the wall held back the noxious tide until the tide began to climb. Fluttershy rose higher and sprinted for her cottage on the town outskirts. Placed on a hilltop as it was, the home had seemed pointless to fortify. But now...
Captain, Cassandra is in Corona. She's attacking Rapunzel.
Get off the ground! The walls won't stop it! It's coming! Hurry!
Back in the middle of town, the air was thick with the stench of the purple muck and the sounds of ponies shouting and screaming and crying. Twilight and Rarity stood side by side, backing away from the roiling slime pouring through the street. Spike stood on the ground between them, weaving to peek between their legs as he followed them in retreat.
You should fly away, Twilight. Those wings aren't just for show, you know.
I'm not leaving you.
Can't you carry her? I could sit on your back and you could...
I don't think I'm strong enough yet to fly while carrying a full-grown pony for long.
She turned to face Rarity.
And I don't want to risk losing you if I carry you with magic, or try to wink you out. One jostle to my horn, and I might lose the spell matrix. We need to find another way.
Rarity nodded. A fresh wave of the slime surged down the street, driving the trio back.
What is this stuff? Ugh, it smells like a used lava bath.
Twilight ignited her horn.
Whatever it is, don't let it touch you. Not even the tip of your tail. Lightning dust said it's dangerous.
She magicked up a rain barrel and cracked it like an egg, brandishing the two broad halves defensively. Rarity's horn flared as she magicked up a spare sheet of burlap and spread it like a matador's cape. She huffed and gave a flick of her tail.
Let that touch my cold fur? I assure you, Twilight, that is the last thing I will do.
Yeah.
away, Twilight Sparkle galloped along the untouched upper walls of downtown Ponyville's buildings as if they were level ground. Her horn blazed from the gravity-bending spell, and Spike was clinging to her back between her spread wings, still and silent. Twilight vaulted the chasm that was a side street and skidded to a stop near an abandoned cart on the wall that was the ground. She magicked up the cart and smashed it into a narrow alleyway, wedging it in place and blocking the vile flood's path. She released the spell and flapped onto open ground. Her stance wavered for a moment from the vertigo of realigning up and down.
That's all the major side streets. That should slow it down and buy us a little time.
Time to do what?
Spike huddled on Twilight's back, feeling small and useless. Twilight's expression hardened.
Time to prepare. We're evacuating.
Quick, everyone to the castle! We'll be safe there!
Now, on to new business.
Thank you. Cybertron has fallen. Get to the escape pods. There are other Autobots scattered across the galaxy. We must reach them if we hope to survive.
Optimus, this is our home. We have to fight for it.
We will fight on, but we must find refuge first. I found a planet that's well hidden. Earth. You will travel there and establish a base for us. Once we've gathered the others, we'll join you. You must protect the planet. If the Decepticons find it, then our people are truly